going to talk now about birds. They make such a wonderful subject for my watercolors. What I'm going to do is mix up some colors for this quail. And this quail, I know this quail very well. His name is Hope, and a darling friend of mine rescued him. So he's got all sorts of wonderful personality quirks, and he's quite delightful. And whenever she writes to me, she gives me one of Hope's little feathers. But he's got this top knot, if that's what you call that on a quail, I'm not sure. I've gone into my watercolor, Payne's Gray, picked it up, loaded up my Miracle Wedge brush, and I'm going to do a little dollop there of wet and pull it right down to meet the top. So the quail's top knot has come out of the picture. But this is calling for attention too. I want to make this an interesting picture. So I'm going to pull the stem or the branch that Hope is sitting on. I'm going to clean my brush and make the top of the stem just a little lighter to reflect that the light from above. But don't you see how much more interesting that is as a greeting card than simply the image? We've brought the image out in two places. Another card I have is the Great Blue Heron, and that sells very well. And this handsome creature is among grasses and reeds. So I'm going to go over to my palette and make a few puddles of reed colors. I'm going to use Hooker's Green and I guess a sienna. And oh, I know, I'm going to come over here and use a bit of this color, yellow ochre. I'll start with a yellow ochre, mush a little green in, and come over and just carry on doing some reed shapes. I'm coming out of that rectangular painting I did, and that again makes the image more interesting, makes the viewer want to look at it a little bit longer. And I now need to just darken up some of those because they're a bit on the light side. So you can see this is almost like calligraphy. I'm just making long skinny marks. I'll bring one up here and flop it over, and I think that's done. But doesn't that look nice? And now I have a blackbird. It's amazing how popular the blackbird is. And he's a very, very simple enhancement. I'm over here in my the dark, I'm blanking the color now, but dark colored, very dark blue, indigo. Thank you, it finally came to me. I'm going to pull this branch right out. Oops. I made it a little bit thicker there than I like. So let's see if I can get away with that and possibly correct it. As my dad would say, a man on a galloping horse wouldn't notice the difference. I think I'll have to bring it to the blackbird or the crow. Yeah, that's fine. That works. I'm going to now show you some other enhancements that I've done. I won't be demonstrating them, but I'll just show you. The hummingbird. That delicate creature, its wings go so quickly that my enhancement for the hummingbird is simply to put some glitter sparkle right on this under wing, and it seems to work nicely. It makes it more interesting. And this pelican, well, he's floating in that sparkly wet water, so that I would have used the glitter glue to get that effect. I also use the glitter glue on the rooster because sometimes you see roosters and they have such wonderful color in their dark, dark tail feathers. And the glitter glue gives you a hologram effect. So he's strutting his stuff and he's got that sparkle on him and he's great. And then finally, there's the flamingo. And I was thinking, how can I enhance him? I actually started by putting a thick gel that hardens on his eye, which makes his eye very interesting, but he needed something else. So I used a very bright neon pink and pulled some of a suggestion of his feathers out of the picture.